Hi, this is Joe Bass with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Glad you've seen this video today. I got some things I want to show you. Let's start over again. I thought that was call for me. I'm sorry.
Good.
Hi, this is Joe Bass with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Thanks for watching this video today. I hope you enjoy this presentation. I'm not only going to talk about this RV, but a little bit of bass fishing as well. Because look, why do we buy these things, folks? We buy them to go outside and have fun. And what better way to have fun is to go out to your favorite lake with a nice little trailer in your truck and enjoy the day going out with your partner bass fishing, or going out in a canoe bass fishing, or whatever it may be, or fishing along the shore or out on a dock. What a great time to just kind of have fun and enjoy yourself. I'm going to talk about something about bass fishing today. It's called drop shotting. I don't know if any of you ever heard of drop shotting before. It's one of the most effective ways to bass fish in any lake, especially a high pressure lake, or in a lake where there's a lot of ledges and rocks, and it's called drop shotting. Now I'm going to show you how my rod's set up. I'm using a 6-foot light action spinning rod. This is a Lama glass. And this is a 6'6", and it's a 662 rod. It's an 8 to 15 pound line weight. They call it a medium light, and you can see it's got a lot of action at the tip. I use 6 pound line fluorocarbon that I use, and the reason why I use that is because usually in high pressure lakes, fish are a little bit more skittish of line, so I use a fluorocarbon light line, 6 pound. And then I use a drop shot weight, which is this cylindrical weight that has a little clip at the top so you can clip it onto your line. And if you notice how this hook is tied, see how the hook is facing upward? And the reason why that is because when a bass hits that, they're going to take the bait and this hook is going to drive right into the top of their mouth. And they're not going to be able to let it go because it's going to grab the top of their mouth and they can't spit it out. I use a reel. This one here happens to be a Quantum Energy. It's a great reel. They call it a titanium. And it's got great action. It's quick. I like it, especially for drop shotting. Lightweight. And I use Gary Yamamoto's 4-inch Senkos as my drop shot bait. And I want to show you one of these and how you hook it up. This is the drop shot bait right here. You can kind of see it, got a nice oily finish on it. The color of this one is a brown and black flake. And what does it represent? It represents almost anything. You know, bass are hitting this more because of the action of it more than anything else. You take this right here, see how it is right there? I'm going to hook it up so it wiggles around, just like so. And that hook is very sharp, by the way. I'm using a 1-aught wide gap hook by Gamagatsu. And so when that's in the water, this weight is at the bottom wherever it's hitting, and I'm twitching it, and look what's happening with that bait. Bass cannot resist that. This is called drop shotting. One of the most effective ways to bass fish. If you can't catch bass any other way with lures, Rapalas, crankbaits, spinnerbaits, you tie something like this on and you hang on, folks, because you'll fill your boat up in no time. Called drop shotting. And use this trailer here. This is a Nomad. This is built by Skyline RV, and it's a small little unit. It's a 13-foot tow trailer. It's fully equipped with propane tank. It's got an awning. It's got outside speakers so you can have fun and listen to your music outside. And it's a single axle, super lightweight, only weighs 2,000 pounds. And you can tow this with a little Jeep, you can tow it with a Nissan pickup, you can tow it with whatever you want. So it's real lightweight, but it has lots of storage. It's also got a little bed that kicks out the back. They call this a hybrid, and that's what makes it lightweight. Let's go take a look at the inside. And there's not room for both of us in there, so I'm gonna let my cameraman go in there so you can see the inside. You see it's got a full kitchen up front with a CD player right underneath the microwave. And that door right there goes into the bathroom, and it's what they call a wet bath. So you can do the three S's all in one spot. And I'm not going to say what the three S's are. You can read between the lines. And it's got your bed in the rear with an air conditioner, single door fridge, lots of storage. Got a small little furnace right there underneath that storage compartment. This also has a high definition TV antenna on the roof. And we can throw a TV in here for you too if we need to make it work for you. So when you're going out having fun, hook your truck up to this little Nomad right here, throw all your rods in it, head out to the lake, have some fun bass fishing. And if you want to talk about bass fishing, I'd love to do that. Ask for Joe Bass here at the RV Corral. Remember, ask for Joe Bass, and I'll make sure you get a free gift. Thanks, folks.